Technology. It shapes and reshapes our world. The hardware and the software make us aware of better ways of doing things. For work or for leisure, technology can improve our lives and re-energize our lifestyles. We can create it or we can adapt it. The technology of the present can help us prepare for a future perfect.
Hi, I'm Tony Velasquez. The idea of the Philippines becoming a hub for auto design may raise a lot of eyebrows, especially since the country has not produced any locally designed vehicle of note. But that could soon change. The Pasig-based company Michel Motorsport has been tapped by a British investor to design an electric sports car to be distributed soon in Europe. In fact, the Michel Gitano is set to be shipped to the SEMA Auto Trade Show in Las Vegas this week to share the stage with more than 1,000 custom cars from all over the world. And joining us here on Future Perfect to talk about the project is Michel Motorsport President and CEO, Jan Kierulf. Jan, thanks for coming to the show.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, did you ride the Michel Gitano to the studio?
Well, I wanted to, but we're still
prepping it up. MMDA.
Oh, sir, wala pa license.
Yeah, is the Michel Gitano a road or street legal vehicle?
Yes, soon to be, yeah. Mm-hmm. Actually, there was a first prototype that was done in Oregon. Okay. Just to test the powers, the whole drivetrain, the engine.
The drivetrain, okay.
Yeah, and it's really, really fast.
Really fast?
Really fast.
Now, I want you to quantify what really fast means. For the MMDA, really fast is over 60 kilometers per hour.
Whoa.
How much faster does this go?
Okay, a 0 to 60 time would be about 5.5 seconds.
All right.
It could go as fast as 190 kilometers
per hour. Top speed, 190 kilometers per
hour. Yeah, we're just limiting it. But it could go faster than that. Yeah.
All right. Now, let's begin with the basics of how the design came about. Did I pronounce it right? Michel Gitano.
Yes.
Okay, Gitano. Yeah. Now, how did the basic design come about? This was a collaboration of Michel Motorsport with another company?
Well, actually, what happened was brainstormed about the entire design. Mm. Initially, it was a conceptualizing phase that involved purely Filipinos.
Ah. Yeah. So Filipino what? Motorsport enthusiasts or local car assemblers? Sino to mga to?
Okay. Well, the primary person here would be a guy who graduated from Art Center in Pasadena. He's a Filipino. His name is Christopher Lacson. Okay. Really good guy.
Yeah. Nice. And Christopher and Chris Lacson.
He's the chief designer of the car.
And did he work for any previous employer in the car industry?
Sort of on a personal projects with friends, mm-hmm. and other projects involving not just cars but motorcycles.
Motorcycles. Yeah. Dito, sa Philippines or sa US?
US and then Philippines.
Okay. Yeah. And then Chris Lacson and a couple of other guys.
Yeah, myself, Mr. Reggie C, Michael mm-hmm. De Leon. All of us are basically car enthusiasts.
All right. Yeah. So you like to tinker with engines? You like take them apart, put them back together?
Right? Yeah, you can say like that. I'd like to get my hands dirty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Grease monkeys, as they would say.
Yeah, or motorheads, gearheads.
Motorheads. Yeah. All right, but so you got together. How long ago was this when you first conceptualized the design for the Gitano?
Well, surprisingly, the whole process took a mere 9 months.
From 9 months before?
Yeah, from wow. 9 months. Yeah, it's really, really fast. Mm-hmm. We just like started like
a... Ano to?
Okay.
Usapang inuman ba ito na parang ganda sigurong gawa ng sports car na electric ano?
Medyo.
Yeah, na sinasabi ko. Yeah. Always a battle for inspiration.
Well, yeah.
So you got together 9 months before, yeah. and you thought of doing or creating an electric sports car. Hindi lang to just ordinary sedan. It's yeah. a sports car. What was the inspiration for that?
Okay.
Aside from the bottles.
All right, the bottles sort of like kept us flowing.
Yeah,
yeah. But the inspiration actually is more of the concern of everybody for the environment. Let's face it, you know, it's getting hot already. Mm-hmm. So the hotter it is, the more clouds form, and the more clouds form,
the more storms we get.
It all goes down.
Yeah.
So that's your floods.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're thinking more about reducing the carbon emission, you know, from vehicles.
Yeah. It was it all started like that. More
all
like, it's a concern for what's happening right now.
Yeah. Now, you could have gone the simpler way of designing an e-vehicle, which is what...
That looks like a toy.
Well, exactly, because e-vehicles are now beginning to catch the curiosity and maybe imagination of a lot of people.
Yes.
But why go for an e-sports vehicle, sports car, right away? Why not just an ordinary e-sedan?
All right. Well, a sports car is like a halo project to us. No? Mm. So it sort of attracts everybody's attention to what the car can achieve. And there has been a lot of naysayers, traditional petrol heads like what I used to be would go for like V8 engines, really fast, you know.
Okay.
We want to set the bar a bit and then establish the performance first.
Nah.
And then probably after that we go for like a smaller sedan.
So show the potential, no? Because
when
people think about e-vehicles, they normally think about, these things are like golf carts. I mean, they probably go 40, 50 kilometers per hour, and then you run out of charge in maybe 3 hours.
Yeah, and you're left in the road.
And you're left, you're stuck on the road.
Yeah.
Now, this vehicle, as you said, goes to 0 to 60 in maybe 5.5 seconds, mm-hmm. top speed 190 kilometers per hour.
Yeah.
Just how much electric charge does this thing run on? I mean, how long does it go on a single electric charge?
Okay, a single electric charge is about 6 hours charging. All
six
depends.
6 hours charging. Okay.
It all depends. You can get the best charger, stage 3 will set you back by so much, but it charges in a mere 90 minutes.
Fast charger.
Fast charger.
And then?
And then for the batteries, we have a battery pack, 110 battery packs for this car that will take it to about 160 kilometer range.
Ah, yeah. Okay. 160 kilometer range.
Yeah, but
what working at what speed are you talking about? Not at 190 kph.
No. Yeah, it was the faster you press, the harder you press on the pedal,
the more discharge the battery.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you're running at about an average of 60, which is like the average speed limit, so you could get about 160 kilometer range.
Oh yeah, by driving 65.
160 would be Manila to Pangasinan.
Lampas Angeles. Yeah, probably, yeah.
Angeles, further than 82 that. Kilometers lang yun.
Tarlac.
Tarlac.
Yeah, more than Tarlac.
So, pwede ka nang dumating sa Hacienda Luisita, busina ka sa harap ng Hacienda nila Pinoy, tapos tirik na yung auto.
Well, yeah, that was also one of the questions asked to us.
Paano kung tumirik na? Wala nang battery.
Okay, well, what we have here is actually a different concept, which is actually, I think, the stopgap solution before all the battery costs go down. It's called the series hybrid.
All right.
A series hybrid is an onboard generator that charges the batteries on the fly.
Oh.
Yes.
So you never discharge the batteries?
Never discharge.
But they're always... So it's like parang may alternator ka lang.
Yeah, oversized generator, alternator.
Okay.
Yeah, so manual press, or if you preset it at, half discharge, it charges again.
Charges again.
Yeah.
And it charges through this onboard generator.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the generator runs on?
Well, it could run on any clean fuel like ethanol.
Mm-hmm. For the Gitano,
CNG.
What do you use?
Right now, we're using gasoline.
Regular unleaded.
Yeah, regular unleaded. E10.
E10.
Yeah, E10.
Okay, E10. So,
E10
okay,
muna.
May ethanol blend.
Yeah, may ethanol
10%
blend.
10% ethanol blend.
Yeah.
Now, how much went into the design of the car, cost-wise?
Okay. You're looking at different stages. Mm-hmm. So, I'd say the hard forming and sculpting of the whole design probably set you back by half a mil.
Pesos?
Yeah.
Pesos. Okay.
Yeah.
Half a million pesos.
Yes. And then...
sculpting, meaning to say you formed it out of... what material do they normally use for auto designing?
A very huge block of styro. Styro.
So manually sculpting the styro.
Okay. Well, this is where the fun starts. And this is where the tech part kicks in.
Kicks in.
Yeah. So nowadays, sculpting and forming is easier. Okay. The biggest effort actually is in the conceptualizing phase. Yeah, so you have what do you call as printing machines.
Platters.
Yes, four axis, three-dimensional slicers and cutters.
CAD-CAM platters.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, and you have a software. You start with SolidWorks. That's the most basic. Mm-hmm. And then you move to, advanced softwares like CATIA and Rhino. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, of course, our viewers are probably wondering why Jan and I are sitting surrounded here by a couple of mean-looking robots. Do you think that robotics would soon play a major factor in making the final design for the Gitano?
Well, it's pretty much still human effort.
Human effort.
When you design and everything. The cutting part, that's automated.
Automated, yeah.
Yeah, you have laser cutting.
So cutting the styrofoam block into, the shape of the body.
Yes.
So $500,000 just went into that. And then
That's the service part. Yeah, the service fee.
So what's the final price tag on the Gitano?
A one-off will set you back really high because it's the first, but when it goes into production, then you start looking at the numbers. Mm-hmm. You have an MOQ, minimum ordering quantity, for parts that you get. Mm-hmm. This is pretty much a low volume exercise. It's a niche market.
Sure.
Sports car.
Yeah.
So like pretty much like the.
So it's made to order. It's like if you were a Ferrari, you'd actually customize the car for the buyer.
Color,
yeah. Seat interior.
Appointments inside, yes.
Okay, so how much would it set you back? Binibitin mo ako eh. What's the price
Okay, time? Well, in the UK,
tingnan ko, nandito wallet ko, lalabas ko na.
Yeah, okay. In the UK, they plan to sell it at 65,000 euro.
Yeah. 65,000 euro. Okay, the exchange would be about 62 pesos to a euro
thereabouts, now. Thereabouts.
65,000 euro. So that's too much math for me to calculate now.
Okay,
see. So that would be about roughly what? 36 million.
That's about 3.8, yeah. Thereabouts, 33.8. You'd probably pay more for a Ferrari. Here, you pay for like 16.
Okay.
Yeah, that's 4 million pesos. Mm.
Of course, we're talking about Filipino ingenuity that went into designing this vehicle, right?
Yes.
It is probably one of the first, if not the only, Filipino designed electric sports vehicle, right?
My father's friend started an electric car program in the past, I think 2007. It's called the Eagle. So that's a very good start.
Eagle?
Yeah, Eagle, 2007. They have their shop in West Avenue.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so it's a really good effort, really good design at an electric car.
Your dad did that?
No. That's a friend of my dad, acquaintance.
So the Eagle, we never really heard much about it.
It was like, pretty much in the news.
It was
2007. Okay. Yeah,
2007.
You covered it, I think.
Maybe, maybe our the cobwebs in my mind.
This is something that we don't want to happen again. You know,
makalimutan.
That's why we want to sustain this. Mm-hmm. Want the people to get interested. Yeah, it is a halo project to get the people's interest.
The cost should come down when more people probably think that it can become a standard. Mode of production for e-vehicles.
The stage two is when we start introducing the mass-based cars. Yeah, I've talked to some designers already, Filipino guy again. Sabi ko, let's do a car at 350,000.
Really?
Yeah, smaller car.
Okay. Yeah. But that's still something to watch out for. Sana ganyan din kaganda yung body. No?
Oh, yeah. We'll take the same design cues. It's the design is pretty much a link to the past also. If you see, they have more clearer lines.
Yeah. What does it look like? I'm not really that much of a car connoisseur, but what does it look like? Is it like a Maserati or something?
We took design cues from just about everybody.
Everybody. Ferrari, yeah. Maserati.
Yeah, the masters. Yeah, from Pininfarina, Ital.
Pininfarina.
Bertone.
Magaling talaga Pilipino kumopia, no?
Well, there are some cues
there that are... Datsun. Datsun 180B.
Yeah. Pretty much. Medyo. There are like some Japanese, Italian, and British.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Jan, this model is being shipped off to the SEMA Auto Show in Las Vegas.
Yes.
You did say tomorrow, right? September 15th?
Yeah, we're shooting for tomorrow midnight because the ship leaves Friday.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And so while you're there in Las Vegas, you'll be hoping that some of the visitors to the trade show will find interest in it and hopefully what? Invest in it?
Yeah, open the doors for the U.S. market because basically what we've tapped is the European market.
Okay.
Maybe there are people interested to introduce it in the U.S. But the problem with the U.S. market is that approval, having it federalized, is very steep, very expensive. To get it to run on U.S. roads, you have to probably crash test three cars.
To make it street legal.
Yes, yeah.
Okay, well, you want to make it big in the U.S., of course, but eventually we guys here in the Philippines are hoping that it becomes one of the standard automobiles of the future on Philippine roads.
I'm hoping as well.
Yeah, hoping as well for a price range that hopefully I don't have to dream about, 350,000 pesos. Not bad.
Yeah, we're shooting for that. We want everybody to switch over to electric as fast as possible.
Switch over to electric. All right. Well, are you getting any incentives from the Philippine government at all? Any support?
Mananawagan ako. We need support.
You need support. Yes, of course. But the Philippine government, of course, should be interested in looking at all these alternative vehicles.
Oh, they are. Yeah. The DOE, the DOST, they have active programs already.
Okay. But they haven't contacted you guys yet.
Oh, no, we did. The preliminary. We're still waiting.
Well, please don't hold your breath, Jan.
Yeah.
Jan Kierulf from Michel Motorsport. Thank you and good luck to you guys when you go to the SEMA Auto Show in Las Vegas.
Thank you very much.
Coming up, we take a look at the biggest gathering of IT expert students and enthusiasts in the country. And later in the show, find out what the most beautiful woman in the Philippines, aside from my wife, had to say when she dropped by Future Perfect. We'll be right back.